I'm going to review of Enemy, directed by Denis Villeneuve, a film that follows a history professor who discovers a lookalike of himself in a movie. Okay, so Denis Villeneuve is known for directing a film called Prisoners. It was among a lot of people's favorite films of last year, myself included. And it was just a really well-directed film, and it really kind of gave Denis Villeneuve sort of a name. But there are two things that I do need to mention regarding Enemy and Prisoners. One is that Enemy was made before Prisoners, and two, Enemy is pretty much absolutely nothing like Prisoners, except that they're both mysteries, and that is where they begin, and that is where they end. Essentially, Enemy is this year's Only God Forgives, and my problem with something like Only God Forgives was that the characters in the film were all basically cardboard cutouts. They were completely static. The only real thing that they had going on was that they were all allegories for something else, which is fine. However, I don't believe that completely exempts the characters from having any kind of emotional depth. To me, Only God Forgives just kind of felt like a well-directed, incredibly well-shot student film project, which, when one uses that term, one also uses the word pretentious. I'm not going to use that word, but the film did feel like a student film project. Thankfully, though, Enemy is not like that. Enemy does have some depth, and not only that, but it also has an intriguing mystery that really did kind of keep me on my toes and really kind of had me guessing on what the hell was actually going on throughout this film. So, therefore, I was very much invested. And the mystery does surround, like I said in my intro, does surround a man played by Jake Gyllenhaal who does find out that there is another person living in the world who looks exactly like him. So they meet up. And throughout the entire film, you're really trying to discover, okay, what exactly is going on? You don't necessarily know until you really kind of had all the pieces of the puzzle placed together and there it is revealed. However, there is no big revelation. There is no big, like, aha moment or anything like that. You have to kind of put it all together yourself. And if you don't do that, then, well, you'll probably have to go back and watch the film a couple more times to actually kind of figure out what exactly is going on. However, I did find that aspect to be the most difficult to kind of piece together. In fact, I found that to be the most easy to piece together. And there's also a lot of interesting imagery to be found throughout the film, and it's really all of this I found to be the most essential when it came to deciphering the film's message. So if you're someone who hasn't seen the film yet, then I would highly recommend paying attention to the little things. But what I also really like about the film is that there is a little bit in the film where Jake Gyllenhaal is given a history lesson about communism and dictatorships and all that stuff, how they essentially began. And they begin by kind of feeding the masses entertainment as a distraction so that the government can kind of do whatever they so please. And this is something that I do believe more people should be aware of. And I'm not trying to be like a conspiracy theorist here, but to think that the government doesn't take advantage, keyword advantage, of entertainment, you'd be fooling yourself. And one other thing before I start talking about some of the things that I didn't like about Enemy is that, like Prisoners, it's also very well directed. Okay, so now for the problems with Enemy. My problem with Enemy is that it's obviously the kind of film that does require multiple viewings to fully understand. And my problem with that is that, unlike films like 2001, Taxi Driver, I mean, I'm going to throw in Memento and Inception, those films do require multiple viewings. However, my attraction to those films wasn't necessarily because of the mystery or the complexities that lied in those films. No, it was really because those films were great. They had great characters, incredible direction, cinematography, overall just great stuff to really go back and revisit. Enemy really didn't have that other than the mystery. Outside of the mystery, there's really nothing for me to sink my teeth into. By the time the film ended and the message was revealed, I kind of walked away from the film saying, that's neat, but that was really it. The two Jake Gyllenhaal characters, they do suffice only because of the mystery that surrounds them. Yet outside of the Saren Gaden character who plays the wife of one of the Jakes, I really didn't find any of the characters to have too much emotional depth. Again, outside of the mystery that surrounds the two Jake Gyllenhaal characters, I really didn't find those two characters to be all that interesting, nor all that likable. And one thing I do need to say is that the film is well shot. However, the yellow color tint is something that I probably could have done without. It kind of reminded me a little bit of urine, which is not exactly a good thing to be reminded of. Throughout the film, I was trying to figure out if the film was actually trying to say something by having such a tint, but I'm not entirely sure that was the case. Overall, if you're someone who doesn't mind characters not being the centerpiece of a film and you're someone who enjoys great puzzles, then Enemy is definitely meant for you. So I'm going to give Enemy a low 3.5 out of 5. As always, I'm Colin Kirkland, and thank you so much for watching.